Janisha from St. Joseph Composite PU College, Vijaypur. And dealing with economics subject. Today, in this new episode, we are going to discuss about new chapter, that is MRB, chapter 4, poverty. Before going to the discussion of this chapter, we just revise previous chapter, that is liberalization, privatization and globalization. As you know that under this chapter, economic policies, economic reforms were introduced, and also the outcome, the result of the economic reforms, so which effect on our Indian economy. There is a lot of changes having takes place in our Indian economy. And this economic reform policy, its major aim was that is to maintain the and the main aim of this LPG policies or economic policies, that is to uplift the economy, that is to welfare of the people, by what? That is by removing the quantitative restriction and also handovering the and also give much importance for the private sector, and what? Integrating our economy into world economy, right? But in the criticism part, we observe that the problem of poverty, unemployment still existed after introduction of this, what, 1991 policies. What are the causes of poverty? Why still we face the problem of poverty? Why it is one of the crucial problems to our Indian economy? And what is the role of government and how the government performs its function to remove the poverty? So those things we'll discuss from this chapter. The main aim of independent India was, that is, reducing poverty, and also providing basic necessities or basic needs, amenities. One of the important aim of independent India government, that is to reduce the poverty. Reducing the poverty, how? That is by providing the basic needs, basic amenities to the people. Basic amenities or basic needs is what? That means food, clothes and shelter. What the goal of an independent India? Because our India, because in our country we face one of the crucial problem, that is what? Poverty. So for that reason, in order to uplift the economic welfare, social welfare of the people, the government will make so many programs, policies implemented, and also government implemented so many policies and programs. Now let me discuss in detail regarding this chapter. And also, poverty is not only a challenge for India. Remember, poverty is not only a challenge for India, as more than 1/5 of the world's poor live in India alone. But for the world where about 300 million people are not able to meet their basic needs. earth has many phases, so which change from place to place and also from time to time. So in order to this, try to reduce the poverty, we should know about what is the condition of our country's poverty, what is the condition of our economy's poverty, world poverty. Then only we can try to find out some solutions to eradicate the problem of poverty. Okay, so that in order to identify how about this problem, we first know about who are poor. Who are poor people? Okay, then how it classified? Then let me discuss who are the poor. Who are the poor? So poor means poor people we can observe in both the urban areas and in the rural areas. Then in the rural areas, whom we call poor people, and in urban areas, whom we call poor people. Okay, so then pushcart vendors, street cobblers, women who string flowers, rag pickers, vendors and beggars, so they are called as urban poor because they are living in urban areas. Okay, vulnerable people, that is vulnerable, under the vulnerable condition they are living in urban areas, and so these people called as a what? Poor people. So pushcart vendors, street cobblers, women who string flowers, rag pickers are also vendors and beggars. They are all urban poor people. Then what is the feature of this urban poor or urban poverty? That is, they are designed in kachcha hutments with walls made of baked mud and also roof made of grass, thatch, bamboo and also wood. And most of them do not have even dwellings also. Okay, so this is what urban poor, or the feature of urban poor people. Okay, so their residential place, or they are residing in where? That is in the kachcha house, that is made up of a mud, okay, roof, and also roof that is made up with the grass, thatch, bamboo as well as wood. Okay, so these people called as a poor people in the urban areas. Then who are poor in rural areas? So they are landless farmers. Even though if some people having land, that means even though if they are having land means that is with a dry or waste land. So these people are poor, that is in the rural areas. Rural areas are rural poor people. So those who have landless means those who are landless farmers, okay, or with dry or waste land, so them called as a rural poor people. And one of the main feature, that is many of them do not get to have even two meals a day. Okay, many of them do not get two meals, that is what, per day. So that is what poor people in both the rural areas and the urban areas. So that is why remember, so rural poor and urban poor, so both are different, but the rural poor in the sense they are living in rural areas, and urban poor people they are living in urban areas. Now let me discuss about what are the features of poor households or poorest households. Remember starvation and hunger. So these are the two key features of poverty. Okay, so starvation and hunger. Along with this, what these remaining what features also for poverty? That is starvation and hunger. Second one, lack of basic literacy and skills. That means poor people, they have not get what, education or literacy. So as a result, due to the lack of basic literacy and skills or efficient skills, as a result they will not get economic opportunities. Means there is a limited scope of economic opportunities, that is for poor people. That is because of the lack of a basic literacy and also skills. Next, fourth one, unstable employment. Why this is because unstable employment? Because I said already, due to the illiteracy, due to the lack of skills. Okay, so they are not getting a stable employment opportunities. This is also feature of poverty. And fifth one, malnutrition. So these people, poor people, they are not getting a proper nutritious food because of their what? Because of their lack of economic condition. So as a result, they will not get a proper nutritious food, and it will create what? Malnutrition. And there is no access to electricity. Most of the poor people, especially in the rural areas, they are not access to electricity, and their cooking fuel is a firewood, cow dung, the cake. That means they are not using a modern cooking method. So their cooking fuel is what? That is firewood. That is cow dung cake. And eighth one, they do not have a safe drinking water. So this is also one of the feature. Why? Because see, I said already, malnutritious. Okay, they do not have a proper nutritious food, including drinking water also. They are not accessing a proper safe drinking water, and also gender inequalities. That is male and female. What inequalities, male and female ratios inequalities. So this will also one of the feature. And last one, less care on to motherhood. So here there is a lack of caring to motherhood, as well as the, due to the malnutrition, as well as the what, there is unable to access a safe drinking water. So this will affect on what? Motherhood. And as a result, what it affect on what? Child. So that mother as well as child care also neglected or ignored in the for poor people. So this is what the features of a poor households. Okay students, so in this episode we have learned that then who are poor, then what are the features of poor people, poor households, and how we classify the poor according to the areas, urban areas as well as the rural areas. So in the next class, we'll discuss further more concepts regarding this chapter. So now, some of the exercise questions of this chapter, that is, first question, who are urban poor's? Example. Question number two. What is the key feature of poorest households? Question number three. What is the aim of independent India? And question number four. What are other features of poor housing? Dear students, everyone need to write this question with answer and submit it on time. Thank you.